Hey everybody, welcome to Lift Rain Tool On, and this week's episode of Ryobi Weekly, we have an information-packed episode this week, so stick around. Starting off, I didn't see any new tools that have came out. I think they came out earlier in the month to kind of speed up for some of the releases that's coming out recently over the past couple weeks. No real new deals either for Black Friday. I waited till today, the day after Thanksgiving, to make the video because I wanted to make sure that I was getting the best deals up and I was talking to you about them. Well, nothing really changed that I saw. If you all saw something, put the comment down in the section below. But I did find that they were pretty consistent across the board. We had some great deals going on this month, so we just had a little bit more time to take advantage of those. Going over to Direct Tools, which is the wholesaler for Ryobi and some of the other tool brands, they're doing a 50% off daily deal. So if you hit that, you're going to see some specialty tools there, and they're going to be 50% off. So check that out. You may get lucky. They do have their giving right now, so Thanksgiving that's 20% off. That's pretty standard for Direct Tools, and then they also just have their deep discounted tools. So if you're lucky, maybe you'll get the tool that you're looking for there. You'll get them cheaper than you would in a typical score. You may just have to wait, and you may get a blemish tool, so please be aware of that. As we start to skip into the groups, some of the fan pages over at Ryobi Revolution, Matthew Robbins, he's done something pretty cool. Him and his team, they've went to Australia and they've imported some of these heavy-duty Ryobi scissors. And I've got to tell you, they're thick, they're very beefy, they're very comfortable, and they're very sharp. This is plastic packaging. Cuts it with no issues at all. Something completely unrealistic, this is 1-inch foam board. Cuts it with no issues at all. It cuts a bunch of stuff. Now, it's not just for paper, but they do it for wire stripping. They advertise it saying that it can do a lot of stuff. Now, I don't think it can do everything, but I can tell you what it's going to be used for around my house. It's going to be used for cardboard. It's going to be used for some of those heavier items that you necessarily wouldn't want to use your typical scissors for. Now, I've had some heavy-duty scissors in my time, and these are better than a lot of my Fiskars and some of my other higher-end scissors. I'm actually pretty impressed. These are not gimmicky like some of the other tool brand scissors. These are actually heavy duty. Now, Matt had these priced for a reasonable price of $30 a piece, and that included shipping. And that's a bargain for this considering he imported them from Australia. And if you don't know how much it costs to import tools, you may want to look it up. With that being said, Charles Heyman actually got a set of these, and he wanted to go ahead and customize them, so he went ahead and built a holster for them. Two different types, one you can screw against the wall and then one you can use on your pegboard. And it's pretty fascinating because it has a window that goes around the Ryobi, and then it has a nice little slot that goes for the assembly screw in the middle. Pretty clever design. I talked to Charles. So good for you, Charles, for rapidly making some of these and getting it available. I know there's a lot of interest in them. Very awesome things. Great effort on people's abilities to get out there, to be innovative, to import these things. Yeah, I really appreciate it. I know a lot of people around the community too, and you're bringing together two different countries here and getting two different offerings together. Maybe this will motivate Ryobi to pull some of these hand tools and get them to the United States as well, and maybe vice versa, they can get some of the tools we have here to Australia and to the UK and to some of the other countries as well. Now let's head over to the Ryobi Rebels page. This is Alan Orsak. Now he's been featured on this channel before, or on the updates, but now he's posted a video and it's showing him rapidly sinking multiple different fasteners with his, what it looks like, as I can see it, if I'm right, let me know, Alan, a P238 three-speed brushless HP tool. You can tell he's been doing this for a very long time if he's that precise in getting these fasteners sunk. Now we're going to head over to the Ryobi Tools Fans page, UK. This is Francis Cowell, and he's doing a wide-angle shot. He's in his workshop, and you can see he is surrounded. That's a sea of green all the way around him. He's getting it organized. It's a really cool setup. I love how he has everything around him, but it's just going to show He has pride in the Ryobi brand, so right on. Thanks for showing this picture. Love to see this type of stuff. Keep it up. Now we're going back to Ryobi Revolution, and this is Joseph Largen. Now he posts a lot of videos, and he's an admin of the group as well. He does a lot of stuff to support the community, and he was really paying homage, and he made himself a complete Ryobi shop. No, it's not just a regular Ryobi shop. This is a party shop, as you can see. Check out this video.
I have my new garage set up.
That is a voice activated, it looks like under lightings, under his pegboards, so he can change the lights. He has music going. So he's not only working, he's having a super fun time as he's working. He has decals on the wall. Right on, Joseph. I love to see this type of stuff. It's pretty innovative. I know a lot of people have done that before, but I encourage people, post your videos, post your pictures, post them in the comments even. I'd love to see what you're doing. And if you'd like to be featured on this channel with some of the great stuff you've done with Ryobi Tool organization, and then how you've built your shops with Ryobi Tools, hey, I'd love to show it too. Let's support the community and let's share some of this great stuff. Now, as you can see, I have a brand new Ryobi hat on here. These are hats that I'm making. You know, this is a lot of fan products out here. So if you're interested in these, go ahead and hit the link down below at my merch store. So next, we're going to talk about Scott Oram. Now, he posts a lot of videos about Ryobi, and he has a strong Ryobi YouTube channel. He is taking the leaf gathering to a whole nother level. Now, we all know that Ryobi has the vac attack, where it sucks up and mulches the leaves. He wanted to take that to a new level, so he was able to get a Works adapter that goes on your trash can so he can use his vac attack and suck those leaves up. So in this video, that's exactly what he does, and it's actually pretty practical. I enjoyed the video. I really wanted to feature Scott because he does a lot for the community. So Scott, thank you so much. Now, I'm not going to say he posts this just on one page. He posts this on his YouTube channel. So you can go to Dad It Yourself, check out his YouTube channel. You can look at any of the groups and you're going to see a lot of his videos as well, because he likes to spread the wealth, and that's good because he's showing us a lot of cool stuff. So thanks, Scott. We'll look out for your next video. So it would not be a special Thanksgiving episode if we did not talk about food. And Joe Lang, he put together a picture, and I'm not sure if Joe did this first or if he just reposted it, but as you can see, we have a Ryobi seasoning spreader. We have the mixer. We have the baster, the potato masher, the carving knife, and then there's three or four other ones. So he's went ahead and he's taken those Ryobi tools and he's preparing you, because Ryobi Kitchen is a thing. I got a laugh out of it. I loved it. Joe, keep doing what you're doing. He's been featured on this channel before, but he keeps coming back with the new and funny stuff. So thanks. And like I said, I'm not sure if he was the first to post it, but I saw it through him first. So hey, good job, man. Gobble, gobble. I actually posted a video this week of the previous top-of-the-line brushless Ryobi reciprocating saw, and I really loved it. I made a video of it a long time ago. I was really proud of it because I never owned one so good. Well, then all of a sudden, boom, Ryobi comes out with the new HP tools, and there's a new one. I did a head-to-head. I really matched them up. I put them side-by-side, and the results, well, they weren't surprising, maybe a little bit, but to see the performance difference between the HP, the new technology, then the old HP, well, it's pretty interesting. So go ahead, hit the link below. Check out that video as well if you haven't seen it already. Next, let's over to the Ryobi Club Denmark. And I'm pretty sure that's Denmark, but they spell it Denmark. So sorry if I'm mispronouncing that. This is one of the cooler things that I've seen. So it looks like Ryobi Denmark, they gave someone an opportunity to kind of do a sweepstakes where they gave them a certain amount of time to run through the warehouse, grab as much as they can get during that time frame, and whatever they actually got to keep. I thought this was a fantastic idea, and Ryobi Tools USA should really think about doing this and promoting and getting out there. So if you're part of that marketing team, take a look at this. Look what they're doing over there. Maybe if you do this here, I'm just saying, I think it's really cool. So you can invite some people out to do that. I know there's a lot of fans on the Facebook tool page. We got thousands of people there, so pick from some of them. I think that people would really benefit from it, and I think it's a great marketing tool as well. So go ahead and check out the video. The link is below. I think you're going to find it hilarious. So I hope everybody enjoyed this video. If you did, hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the notification bell so you don't miss next week's, or the weeks after, or even the previous weeks. You can go back and see those. I appreciate everyone. Thanks for joining. I'll see you in the next video. Take care.